Sense of smell is a sense that we notice the least, underestimate the most. This is methyl salicylate. This is molecule isobutavan. Wow, this is coriander. This is Civetitis civeta. I am Vedat Ozan. I am a writer, perfumer. I am also an olfactory researcher, interested mostly in the perception of odors and the cultural history of smell. Our sense of smell is one of the senses that enables us to communicate with the world. We use it a lot. We smell around 23,000 times a day, which is equal to the number of our breaths. Smell is processed directly in the limbic system of our brain, which is also the processing center for emotions and memory. This is why we immediately travel back in time in a very emotional mood when we smell something from our childhood. Every time we smell something new for the first time, we create a virtual memory card and place it in our memory data bank. Later, when we smell the same substance again, we recall that card back and mimic the emotion which was recorded at that first encounter or impression. Our sense of smell develops before we are born. Therefore, the first data of our memory data bank is the smell of our mothers. Starting from that day, sense of smell is a vital tool for the humankind to survive, and it still is today. That is to say that to have a biological correct offspring, our great-grandparents had to find a correct biological mating partner, which means two different immune systems. You may ask how this happens. With the help of our sense of smell, of course. Our body odor is a reflection or phenotype of our genetic structure or genotype. It is unique to each person, just as fingerprints are, and gives out smell signals for a correct biological mating. These signals start to be emitted only after we reach adolescence and become capable of reproduction. This mechanism, of course, does not function today the way it did tens of thousands of years ago, as we now live in a social world and our pairing decisions are obtained through social parameters rather than hardcore biological ones. Another important and vital role of our sense of smell is related to our nutrition. Although we mistakenly call our perception of food with the word taste, it involves a combination of sensory stimulants, including but not limited to our sense of taste. The most important element of this combination is our sense of smell. We do not perceive odors only through our nose. There are two pathways through which the odor molecules travel. The outer one, which is called orthonasal, and the inner one, which is called retronasal. Smell of the food we chew or drink is perceived through the inner pathway, retronasal pathway, and is this mode of smelling is this major sensory contributor to the total flavor perception. When we leave the smelling option out, like when we have a flu, we are not able to understand or identify what we are eating or drinking. Smell was not only related to reproduction or nutrition. At times when viruses and bacteria were not yet known, foul air and smell were considered to be the reason for all deadly epidemics. It was called the miasma theory of disease. The logic was simply, if bad odors cause black death, use nice ones to prevent or cure them. Therefore, during times of plague, in some countries, doctors wore special costumes and special facial masks, at which the long nose parts, the beak, were filled with nice-smelling things to prevent catching the disease. Later in Venice, these masks evolved to the carnival masks, which can be seen today as some ornaments. As those masks were privileges for men of medicine, rich and noble people carried pomanders instead. Pomanders, or originally pomme d'ambre, were carried in pockets or necklaces or used as belts. They were introduced to France by Catherine Medici. These pomanders were filled with nice-smelling substances like musk grains, neroli or ambergris and used to prevent diseases. Sense of smell is a sense that we notice the least, underestimate the most. It was and still is a vital sense. The problem is that as odor molecules cannot be seen by eyes or held with hands, it is regarded as an abstract sense by majority. In fact, it does not even have a language of its own. We use words or idioms borrowed from other senses to define what we smell. We say, it smells heavy, it smells sweet, it smells sharp. All these defining words are from the languages of other senses. But don't let this lack of spotlights trick you.